Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates. Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I am driving this, the Mini Countryman. This is the second generation model known as the F60. Yes, F60 sounds like a fighter plane, but of course Mini has a lot of inspiration from fighter planes in the center console. Now this is the engine of the vehicle, and when you open the light, well, you can see, I mean, the design is such, you know, there is the space for the headlight over here, and of course the engine bay is quite compact over here. Okay, let's close the engine bay right away. This is the light of the vehicle, really very nice. Obviously it gets LEDs, beautiful ring here, and it gets a projector setup too. This is the fog light of this vehicle, and this is the towing hook. No headlamp washer in this vehicle. Meanwhile, the Mini logo here, and of course because it's a Mini, there has to be multiple colors on this vehicle. You can see the bumper is also sporty. It gets front parking sensors and the S logo over here, because this is the Cooper SD, or rather the Countryman SD. It's actually known as the Mini Cooper Countryman SD. That's a long name, I know, that is a long name. And because this is an SUV, or rather a crossover SUV, it gets body claddings, yeah, from the side and above the wheel arches as well. Now this is a 225 55 17 inch tire, 5-spoke wheels. The disc size is big enough, Pirelli rubber. However, the tire size is actually small for a car which is positioned as a crossover SUV. Meanwhile, there's white treatment on the hood with the bonnet stripes, white treatment on the outside rear view mirrors, white treatment on the roof as well, along with roof rails. S written here, chrome treatment. This is the indicator too. So overall, it does look nice because there's a chrome treatment too. Meanwhile, this is not really a Mini, because this is actually quite big a vehicle comparatively. And as I move around, I should tell you this straight away. This is a very attractive looking car. You also get the chrome treatment here. Beautiful lights. The lights look really very nice. Twin exhaust on both sides, that is. And of course, you get the body cladding which continues. So lower half of the bumper is finished in black. Towing hook is placed here as well. This is the reflector. And these are reverse parking sensors too. Certainly, a Mini Cooper is something which looks very, very, very splendid indeed. And this car is no different. It looks really very nice, doesn't it? But let's quickly get inside, or rather, let's get into the boot of the vehicle right away, which means that I have to press a button here. And there it opens. Countryman is written here. The boot is actually decent size. This is where the manual is placed. There's a 12 volt charging socket here. There are lights placed here on either side. There's space to keep stuff along with a luggage net. And when I open this, I find a spare wheel. That's right, a spare wheel is there inside this vehicle. 115.95.17. So space saver and all the toolkits you ever need. Meanwhile, you want to close the boot, just press a button and there it comes down. Now these features might look handy, but there's a shocking feature which is missing in this vehicle, because all the Mini Countrymans available are in different specs, and because this is actually locally assembled in India, customization options are very limited. I think that doesn't make sense. Being a Mini Cooper, there has to be customization option, but that's not the case here. You can see the door pockets are large enough. You can keep a 1 liter bottle. There's space to keep stuff all over the place, and chrome door handles, chrome button for the power windows. Meanwhile, once inside, you will realize that the scooped out seat back is nice, magazine holders both sides, and of course the space inside is decent enough. There's good amount of knee room. Leg room could have been better. Headroom is decent. Under thigh support is average, I would say, at best. And over here, the cabin is decent size, so obviously you get a center armrest, and all the headrests are adjustable. That's again a nice touch. This is the center armrest. It gets twin cup holders too, and of course in the center there's a slight hump, so it really isn't comfortable for three people. But the cabin is all black. The window area isn't very large as such, and the AC vents placed here. There's a 12 volt charging socket, and that's about it. There's not much to talk about in the rear, because this is not about rear seat. But when you compare to other Minis, yes, the Countryman is the most practical of them all. And you can actually take four people in this car with their luggage for a weekend getaway, not more than that. Although you can see this roof here, it gets twin panoramic roofs with the sun blinds being manually operated. Brings in a lot of airy feeling inside the cabin. Lights are placed here as well, and there are handles on both the sides along with hooks to, of course, keep your coats when you're going for a business meeting. Actually, it's not a business meeting, it's more of a fun getaway with your jacket. That's the reason I have this jacket. I'll just show you how it is actually used. Now the problem is my jacket is so poorly made that it doesn't really have a hook as such to hang on to, but I still try my luck. Yeah, that is how it fits, and yeah, it falls down, so that didn't really work. Anyways, let's quickly get into the driver's seat of this vehicle, and let me tell you straight away, there's good news here, because this Mini Cooper, firstly, doesn't have keyless go, passive entry is not there, but you know what, it gets memory seats, and it gets electric adjust for both the front seats, which is again a very nice touch. Electric adjust is wow. And you know what, under thigh support is not a problem. You can improve the under thigh support by just pulling that out. Dead pedal is there, good amount of space on the floor area as well, and you can see the door pockets are large enough. This is to open the boot of the vehicle. These are the power window controls. This is the control for the outside rear view mirrors. This is to lock and unlock the car. This is the chrome door handle on the inside. And as I get inside, there's so much to talk. Firstly, the seats are extremely comfortable, and the glove box is decent size. It is not really deep, but it is deep enough, I would say. And of course, you get a mirror along with a light, rather two lights, and the shape of everything is so mini over here. In fact, same is the case here as well. Meanwhile, the good thing is that you can keep your toll receipts here. Now, this is obviously the mic input for the Bluetooth system, and these are the controls, the various controls. This is to open the sunroof of the vehicle. Now, the sunroof will actually open, but this sunblind will not go back. This has to be put down manually. Yeah, you have to do it manually. Press once again and it opens more. Decent amount of size of the sunroof, or rather decent size sunroof, I would say. And of course, the mirror is also very nice. It's auto dimming inside your view mirror. Gives a good view of what's behind. Need to press it once again to close it and push it like that. Okay, let's keep it open for the moment. The dashboard design is really very nice and unique. These are the controls for the cruise control. These are the controls for the audio system. This is for voice command. This is to pick up a phone call. And of course, the steering is very nice and chunky to hold it against the piano black finish. The horn is also very nice on this vehicle. And when you actually adjust the steering, which is adjustable for both reach and rake, the instrument cluster also moves along. Yeah, that's right. The instrument cluster also moves along. Meanwhile, this is the instrument cluster of this vehicle. On the left, we get a tachometer. On the center, we get a speedometer. On the right, we get a fuel meter. And below here, we have a multi-information display, which will tell you the temperature as well as the clock, gear position indicator, and eco mode. It will also tell you how much extra you have driven thanks to eco mode. Now, when you're selecting a mode, it will also show you the same over here. That's again a very nice touch. Not much information on offer as such. And this is obviously the controls for the indicators. And this is to browse through the console's multi-information display. So it's going to tell you average speed, real-time speed, and obviously the temperature as well as the distance to empty. And this is the mileage runout. 0.7 kilometers per liter. Meanwhile, these are the controls for the wipers, and using the wiper straight away, let me tell you, the wipers work brilliantly well on this vehicle. You can see there's so much spray on offer, and the same is the case at the rear as well. Yeah, lot of spray, cleans it in no time at all. In fact, you can see the center seat belt is on the top. Well, it is quite usable, I would say. It gets ISOFIX child seat mounts as well. Cabin looks really very nice and dope, especially this day. I mean, this looks very good. However, this is not the top trim. That means that this screen is only a 6.5 inch, not an 8.8 inch screen. And this iDrive controller is also small. It's not big. It doesn't get a touchpad either. This is the electric parking brake. And of course, these are the controls to navigate through this system. Twin cup holders, space to keep stuff here. There's a cigarette lighter here too, along with a USB as well as an aux. And of course, you get an ashtray here, which by the way is very useful. You can remove it and, you know, empty it outside. So overall, you can see there's good amount of space on offer here, because below the center armrest there's space to keep stuff here as well, and inside the center armrest as well you can keep a phone or such. Well, good amount of space on offer without a doubt. Now, these controls are aircraft style. Of course, same are the controls here. These are for the lights, aircraft style. They look very nice and are very good to operate as well, because they make you feel you're operating an aircraft. However, I've never operated an aircraft, so I really don't know how it feels. But anyways, this is to turn on and off the parking sensor. Yeah, front and rear parking sensors on offer. This is to turn on and off the stop start system, and this is to turn on the vehicle. This is the start engine stop button with this red finishing, and it actually makes you feel you're turning on something which is like massively powerful. This is the traction control button, and this is the mode selector button of this vehicle. This is the gear lever. It gets this chrome ring here as well. And of course, this is the hazard light switch of the vehicle. The AC vents are really nice. In fact, if you want to turn off the AC vent, all you have to do is turn them like this, and the AC vent has been turned off. This is the headlight control. This is the headlight leveler. This is for front fog light. This is for rear fog light. And obviously, it gets automatic wipers as well as automatic headlights too. This is the air conditioning control, which is an automatic climate control, and the controls are placed here as well. But there's a problem. Let me get into reverse. I'm in reverse right now. There is no reverse parking camera on offer. There are reverse parking sensors. There are no reverse parking cameras on offer. And the other problem is that at this price, you obviously expect a bigger screen. However, the good thing is when I get into eco mode, or rather in green mode, it shows me a green ring. Yeah, that is right. When I get into normal mode or mid mode, it shows me this yellow ring. When I get into sport mode, it shows me this red ring, which again is a very sporty touch, and I definitely like it. Meanwhile, if I get into the iDrive system, there are the typical things which you see in BMW cars. So obviously, I can get into my Mini right now, and I can get into technology in action, and I can get into sport displays. And of course, this is something which is seen in other BMW cars as well. Ambient lighting on offer as well. So everything which you see in BMW cars is actually there in this iDrive system as well, but it's just customized to look a bit Mini, because the way the display has been done, Mini connected and notifications, everything is kind of different and unique and gives it that mininess in this vehicle. Obviously, audio system is decent and audio quality is good too. Audio quality is really very nice. In fact, this ring also keeps changing the color when the audio is playing. Again, it's a very nice touch. It looks very young, youthful, and obviously funky as well. And I definitely like the interior of this vehicle. Overall build quality is also very nice. Nothing rattles, feels smooth, feels nice, good amount of view of what's around. And of course, because it's sort of an SUV, you can see the hood while driving this vehicle. So definitely a big thumbs up in terms of interior design, but I expected more features. However, how is the car to drive? Well, let's get driving right away. All right, we are driving the Mini Countryman on the racetrack right now, exiting the pit lane. Let me put this car into sport mode now. We are in sport mode. First is, I think, brake testing, acceleration and all these things just to get used to the car. Countryman, sort of an SUV on a racetrack. Well, sounds funny, but let's see what this Mini's got. There's a Clubman right ahead. Again, it's a Cooper S Clubman. It kind of looks weird. Dual wipers on that car at the rear, actually. And here we go. This is the brake test.
Very good job.
Ticks came flying from behind.
Yeah, go.
All right, here we go. Braking test in 3, 2, 1. It shuts off automatically in between. Sounds so good.
Good, perfect.
Now we are doing braking test from 100 km/h. Left foot on the brake, right foot on the accelerator. Revving the motor. Where is the launch control? Not triggering, and off we go. And there we are, 100.
Okay, good job.
Thank you.
Yeah, 100, go.
So after having done brake testing thrice, I think we are good to start driving the car around the circuit. Okay, finally pace car lap. A problem is, there's a big problem actually, there's a Clubman right in front of me, which means that the Clubman is going to be very slow. And of course, you're not allowed to overtake. So let's see how we figure this out. This is still a sighting lap, just getting acquainted with the track. And after that, we start the pace laps and start going faster. So they're actually, I can see the Cooper S in the fleet, Countryman, Clubman, and then we are again in a Countryman. That car is like full on the brakes because the brakes are blinking that way. Using a bit more of the road. Yeah, come on. Yeah, I tired the pressing buttons on the steering, unfortunately. There's a wider line here to get a good exit. And you can hear the tires are screeching myself, but I'm going to use the apex. I'm going to take a wider line from here as well. Understand, and I'm not even on the gas. Here we are on the gas. Instructor is not pulling away. Alright, we're all set to go, which means air conditioning off, turning off the stop-start system as well, getting into sport mode. Yeah, stop-start has been turned off as well. And we obviously get into drive, we get into sport, we turn off traction control too. So one press and it says dynamic traction control, which means that dynamic traction control is still, traction control is active. You keep this button pressed and after a few seconds it will give you the warning. It says dynamic stability control deactivated. So now there is no traction control at all. It's going to spin its wheels like crazy. Left foot on the brake, right foot on the accelerator, revving the motor and yeah, that is the level of wheel spin on offer once you turn off traction control, because this is a front wheel drive car having a lot of power and torque on offer. So this being the Mini Countryman SD, and when you say SD, it is the sporty diesel which is producing a lot of power because this uses a 2-liter engine. It doesn't use the 1.5 liter diesel engine, the 3-cylinder unit which is used in the Mini Cooper. Instead it uses the same engine which does duty on the BMW X1. Now this 2-liter diesel motor is a 4-cylinder unit and produces 190 horsepower and 400 Newton meters of torque. As expected, there's good amount of punch on offer. 0 to 100 kilometers per hour takes around 7.5 seconds. There's good amount of grunt lower down as well. In fact, this motor has punch all throughout the rev range. The mid range is really very strong and it has a top end as well, redlining all the way to 5000 rpm. You want to make a quick overtake, get onto the throttle and all of a sudden the gearbox also responds and the motor also responds very sharply, giving you ample amount of grunt as well as thrust on offer. Yeah, the brakes are a bit too sensitive, I would say. As soon as you get onto the brakes, it will just bite very quickly. Other than that, the engine is a bomb. It is an absolute bombshell. The gearbox also offers really fast shifts, but the only thing is when you want a downshift, it's not the quickest around, and overall refinement level is also very good. Now you must be noticing that this engine actually sounds good for a diesel. Well, don't be too surprised. Firstly, overall refinement is good, but you can hear the dieselness typical of BMWs because they use aluminium, so lighter engine, but obviously aluminium is not able to shield all the dieselness, so that noise is obviously there. However, this car actually emits sounds from its speakers. So there's this sporty snarl which is coming, which is actually coming from the speakers. So yeah, these are fake sounds in the Mini Countryman diesel as well. All right, we're all set to go. Revving the motor to around 2,500 rpm. That's the level of wheel spin on offer. Power is channeled to all the front wheels, that is, not to all the wheels. Now in India you only get front wheel drive. This is underpinned by BMW's UK L2 platform, which also underpins the BMW X1, and you cannot opt for channeling power to the rear wheels or to all wheels, or rather there is no rear wheel power. Actually there is either front wheel drive or all wheel drive, which BMW calls as all four, which is not available in India right now, and I don't think they're going to offer it either. Now of course in terms of performance, there's plenty of performance, not in the same league as the Cooper as the petrol one. The petrol one is just so phenomenal. Again, it's a 2-liter engine, produces similar power, but it just has a soul. It really likes to rev hard and fast and offers great performance and sound as well. There's a JCW2 which again sounds brilliant. Now the USP of this car is of course the handling. It is pinpoint accurate. It is so freaking sharp. It is so freaking accurate. It is unbelievably accurate. I mean, the steering offers great amount of feel and feedback at lower speeds. Obviously it is on the heavier side, but my goodness, the way it weighs up, the handling of this car is sensational. Look at this, okay? Little steering input and it is able to change lanes. That's how brilliant the steering is in terms of offering good amount of feel and feedback. It is just so feelsome. It's one of the best steering wheels in the world. Mini really knows how to make a great steering. Now, of course, in terms of dynamics, this is not as good as the first generation model, which was launched in 2010, got a facelift in 2014. This was launched in 2017, but it's still better than any other SUV in the market now. This is a crossover SUV and it is just so phenomenal in terms of steering feel and feedback. In fact, even the handling of this vehicle is great. Body roll is very well contained, and making a lane change, I mean, look at this, okay? It is as simple as that. Mini really knows how to make cars which work like go-karts, and this one does give you the go-kart feel. Now, obviously this is on the heavier side, weighs 1500 kgs, which is a lot of weight for a car which is known as Mini. Now of course in terms of length, this is 4.3 meters long, which again is quite a lot for a car which is known as Mini. What they've done is they've pushed the wheels on extreme corners, giving absolute poise in terms of balance, and the handling is just sensational. The car is obviously on the stiffer side for that handling, but the low speed ride is horrendous in the sense that it absolutely gives you the jitters. It transmits everything inside the cabin and you can feel a lot of the road, but you know, the ride actually gets better as you speed up, and as the speed builds up, you know, the car kind of settles in. However, at higher speeds you can feel a lot of the road, and especially if you're going at higher speeds and you know, trying to go through corners and you hit an uneven patch, that can be felt inside the cabin. Otherwise high speed stability is great. Brakes perform really well, a little too sensitive for my liking, but overall I would say that the Mini Countryman is also a sensational car to drive. Offers great amount of feel and feedback, and definitely a vehicle which will put a smile on your face whenever you go for a drive, whether it's in the city or out on the highway in the city, because people are going to look at you and be like, oh my god, wow, what a vehicle. Out on the highway, you're just going to enjoy driving this vehicle. Great performance, great handling, and most importantly, I mean, the steering is such a freaking charm. I absolutely love the feel and feedback from the steering. Such a sensational steering wheel. Wow. you will find very few vehicles which after launching then they decide, okay, I think I need to do a wheel spin later on, and that's what this vehicle does. Even after it's off the line, there'll be a wheel spin, because that is the level of lack of traction. No, not really, it's the level of performance and torque on offer. 400 newton meters is a lot. 7.5 seconds to 100, top speed should be well over 210 kilometers per hour, but the overall performance is just something else. It feels such a great car to drive. There are three variants on offer. Two of them are petrols. There's the base petrol, which happens to be the Countryman S, and then there is this, the Countryman SD, the diesel one, and above this there is the Countryman S JCW, the John Cooper Works. The pricing for the base petrol happens to be 42 lakhs, the pricing for the top end petrol happens to be 50 lakhs, and the pricing for this is right in the middle, 46 lakh rupees. Now of course that's a lot of money for a car which actually looks more crossover than SUV. However, it makes you feel special. It offers great amount of performance, and of course it will put a smile on your face every time you see a corner, every time you accelerate as well with the traction control off, because there's just so much amount of punch on offer. This Countryman is a hugely improved car over its predecessor. Yes, it's not as harsh or as sure-footed as before, but it still brings you the smiles, and in terms of crossovers, nothing even comes close when it comes to driving pleasure. Yeah, that's a lot of wheel spin on offer, and after wheel spinning so much, the car kind of gave up and like, okay, fine, the traction control is not activating, I will activate myself and cut power. Any which ways, there are three driving modes on offer. Yeah, three driving modes on offer. There is of course the green mode, which happens to be the eco mode, then there's the sport mode, which happens to be the one I'm driving in right now, and there's the normal mode as well. Now these modes obviously alter various parameters, like of course the engine maps and the air conditioning, the steering wheel, and even the gearbox. I can manually take control of things using the Triptronic function, but the problem is it will not hold on to a gear no matter what I do, and there are no paddle shifters on offer as well. For this price, paddle shifters should have been there, a reverse parking camera should have been there. So in terms of equipment, for 46 lakh rupees you do miss out on a lot of stuff. However, in terms of feeling special, in terms of driving ability, the Mini Countryman does offer more practicality than the regular Cooper, and that's what makes it more appealing to the Indian buyer. So guys, this is my review of the Mini Countryman SD, and if you liked it, you know what you have to do: give it a thumbs up, that's a like button, and also subscribe to the channel. Neha, how do you like the car?
Not worth the price.
Yeah, but everyone keeps asking why Neha is always on the phone. She's actually monitoring the frame. Just show the people the frame in the camera. Yeah, just show. Yeah, so yeah, this is basically monitoring the frame, that where or how is the camera behaving. Anyways guys, bye bye.